We announced the application process a week ago Friday, and by Monday we had over 200 applications.
Hey everybody, I'm Will Glover and I'm here with Rochelle Riley to talk to us about the COVID-19 Artist Relief Telethon. Rochelle, thank you so very much for being with me today.
Thank you very much for having me. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. So first things first, what is the event? Just tell us about it a little bit.
It's an Artist Relief Telethon. We are trying to raise money to help independent contractors. These are the artists who you see in nightclubs, or who work in an orchestra, or who are painters who sell their work at exhibits, and there's no place to perform or to sell because everything's been shut down. So these closures and COVID shutdowns shut down their economy and their ability to make income. So we're trying to make sure that we reach out to them because the city now has an arts and culture office to do that.
With this event, how are we gonna tune into it? Where can people go? What channel are we watching?
Almost everywhere. We are on channel 21 in the city, channel 900 anywhere in the state. We'll be on the Detroit Public Television Facebook page. And if you go to DetroitMI.gov/ACE, which is the Arts, Culture, and Entrepreneurship webpage on the city site, you can see it there. And more importantly, you can donate there. That's DetroitMI.gov/ACE.
We're having a telethon for artists to support the community. Who can we expect to see?
Well, I can tell you that you can see the artists because the whole point of this telethon, the whole point of doing this was to showcase some of the talent and genius that we have in our world-class creative community. So people will know why I'm working and fighting so hard to support them. There are singers, there are acrobatic acts, there are comedians, there are a wonderful artist who is explaining his work. What we ask artists to do is send us videos performing, creating, or talking about their craft. So he actually does some of his work right in his video, which is pretty awesome. And then you'll also, quite frankly, see some amazing people who are already stars who are supporting this and have lent their voices and their names to encourage people to give. Everyone from Jeff Daniels to my partner in this endeavor, Mitch Album, Big Sean, Kim, Hill Harper, Alonzo Bowden, Ant, one of my favorite comedians, along with Alonzo Bowden, and Morgan Fairchild, who is has been amazing for some time. Roland Martin and Ellen Cleghorn, who used to be on Saturday Night Live, they all sent in videos to encourage this community, this Detroit that they love, to support the artists here.
What was it like putting together a lineup like that? Were people eager to participate?
Actually, people were stunned. You know, there has not been an arts and culture office in this city for almost two decades. So all of a sudden, here's this person who was, how can I help? What can I do? Will you send me something that shows your work? And they said, you really just want me, you know, to send you something that I'm performing? Yes, send it in. So once we did that, and we got some amazing footage, some of it is live performance from some artists. Some people sent, like I said, videos where they're just talking about why they love what they do. But my great surprise was the celebrities. You know, we got just as many of those as we did of the artists who literally just said, Detroit, please support these people because they know what it's like. It's true across the country that things got shut down and people got shut down. And while there are all of these amazing initiatives, which the city has been behind 100% just to support small businesses and to make sure that our companies can at some point reopen, this is for those artists who, you know, are either paid in cash or work 1099 to 1099 or, you know, some of them aren't even eligible for unemployment. We wanted to make sure that they knew that this office cares about them too.
How exactly is the money going to help the artists?
I'm glad you asked because this gives me a chance to really thank our sponsors, Huntington Bank and Walker Miller Energy Services, who gave us great donations beyond what we're doing on a GoFundMe page that you can find at DetroitMI.gov/ACE. But our big partner is Metro Solutions. They're an amazing fiduciary that worked with arts organizations around the city, and they are handling all the money. I have no math skills. I would never be, you know, like this on my own. All of the checks are written to them for the ACE fund. There is an ACE fund, and they are distributing all of the grants. And these are no restrictions, $500 grants to any artist that applies for as long as we have the money. So they're doing all of that. All I do is promote and cheer and encourage.
So how do the artists go about applying? If I'm an artist and I see this and I want to pursue that.
We announced the application process a week ago Friday, and by Monday we had over 200 applications. So we had to temporarily close the applications until we raise the money. And if we get a lot of money tonight, that's why it's so important for people to give tonight. If we get a lot of them, we can reopen, because right now it's for artists in Wayne and Oakland counties. And we want to include Macomb, and we want to help everybody who needs it. So we can reopen the applications if people give, give, give.
What is the need? How much are some of these artists hurting?
I'll give you a perfect example. I got a call from one person who literally didn't know because all of the events that she was supposed to participate in for the whole rest of the summer, she said that was her income through the rest of the year. That's sort of how she works. She works all summer, that takes care of the fall. She books things in the fall for the next spring. All of a sudden, in a single afternoon, she got call after call, canceling shows, canceling income. And she was worried about, you know, paying her mortgage and paying her son's school expenses. That's true for anybody who works in art, who is literally counting on the sale of their art or the appreciation of their performance for their paycheck. If they don't get that paycheck, it's just like anybody else, somebody who works in a restaurant or somebody who works in a factory. You don't get your paycheck, you don't pay your bills.
How much money are you hoping to raise? Is there a target number?
When we first announced, we said our target was 50,000, but we hope to hit 100,000 with big donations beyond the GoFundMe. So we hope to get 50,000 by tonight, and we're going to continue through May to try and get 100,000, but I'd love to get a million. I mean, I don't want people to feel like target and then we stop, because there are lots of artists in need. Like I said, we had 200 applications in 2 days. So there would be a lot more if we didn't temporarily stop, just to make sure that we can give money to the people who have asked for it. And then if we get a lot more, we can serve a lot more.
You can find more at OneDetroitPBS.org or subscribe to our social media channels and sign up for our One Detroit newsletter.